Welcome back, my friends, to the next episode of Base Reviews. We were requested to visit another alliance, and only to mention as side notice for all of you who are interested to also get visited by me. If you want to get visited, just leave me a little side notice or a comment below in the comment section how your name is, specifically how your alliance is called. The pronunciation is very important, because if there are any signs missing, it's harder for me to find you. Then give me some special informations, like probably your glory count, your count of medals, amount of members and something like that, whether your alliance is closed or not, because very often there are many alliances which are called or which have the same name, and so it's not easy for me to find the right alliance. And then I will come and visit you if you gave me some names or some battle tags for which players I can go and evaluate. Short, before we start, I can give you a little update about my base. You probably have already recognized that all of my mortars are ready, and these dildo mortars really look awesome inside my base. I could not anticipate having them, because they were the most frustrating updates in the global age, in the industrial age, in my opinion. Because mortars and redoubts, by the way, I don't know why, are the most expensive and the buildings to upgrade with the hugest duration. They are lasting for 12 days each upgrade and costing 7 million, my mortars costing a little bit less because of my research in the university. But so now finally I got all of my mortars, and I think this will strengthen up my defense very, very strongly. I put nearly all of my citizens inside the university, you can see it over here, so I have very, very much implicit and not recognizable, not transparent progress ongoing. So for example, my wall and gate upgrade cost reductions. What complex words. I already researched 3 times, and my walls, like you can see, don't cost anymore 5 million, but 4.85 million. And in the next 8 hours, I think only 4.8 million. So the higher my walls get from now on, the more I will save through this research. Therefore, I intended to make this research as early as possible. My library is also getting ready, and you see I have nearly researched everything. Only some less important oil chapters are missing. Everything ready at stage 1. Stage 2, also everything ready. Stage 3 finished. Stage 4 finished. 5 finished. Also, only over here, the leadership. Sorry. The leadership chapter about my generals. This one is a chapter I also want to research, but I don't want to waste the oil currently. Currently, my first intention is to get my generals up to level 21. Then I can care for the last oil chapters. Also over here, plus 10% bunker health. Let's see. One bunker has about 3,400 health. This means I will get 2 times about additional 341 hit points. That's just pointless. It's nothing at all. Very ridiculous chapter, and you will have to spend, I don't know, 50,000-60,000 of oil? I don't know. I think I won't research this chapter in total. The Gatling gun chapter I will research, but I will use the Gatling guns when I use them, then in Global Age. So currently it's not interesting for me, so I will go for the Internationalism chapter anymore and for the Peace Treaties chapter, and except for this, I have done everything very important in my universe, in my library. Our current World War, there is another World War, and this time it's again I participate. I participated all World Wars 154 currently. The 155th World War, our last World War we did one day ago, I was not participating to give some new active alliance members the chance to participate, and because we had too many guys of us who wanted to come with in the World War, I stopped and did not participate. But now again I'm in. Probably we can just look through the enemy base. They are far more dangerous over here at their description than they are in real. You will see. This guy is Global Age after his description, but in total he's only industrial with some additional buildings. So with a stronger stable and with another additional sniper tower, but in total only very industrial. So very, very equal enemies to our bases. Enemy number two in total is only Industrial Age, so maxed out Industrial Age nearly. I only see a garrison, a bunker, air defense, and a sniper tower. All of the other buildings seem to be maxed out in the Industrial Age, pretty equal to our bases. Enemy number three is Atomic Age, but I don't have to tell you anything about this. I think probably some of you guys have watched my video about evaluating an enemy base, so you all know. Evaluating an enemy base just not comes from seeing which age and level he is, but from seeing how high his defensive buildings are. And so you can easily see we have a global tank depot over here, but in total this guy is at least, I would call it, industrial plus. That should be for the World War update. Let's go into the bases. Here we are at Warrior Kings. Become the best, be active in chat and in the alliance as a whole. Respect is earned and not given. We are growing stronger each day. So, a very pathetical alliance message. I like it. Total amount of members 46. So, I think still growing, but the minimum account or minimum count of medals is about 1,500 medals. That's pretty high. So, they are very reglementing and selecting which members they take. We can also see by their very huge, in relation to other alliances, very huge medal count. You see, they have one guy at nearly 3,000, 2,500, 2,600, 2,400, 300, 300. They have very many. Wow. Nearly all guys above 2,000 medals, some below, but most of them are even higher than in our alliance. So these guys are very obviously focusing on medal chase. The glory count is about 16,100. That's pretty not high. I would call it a little bit average or even a little bit below average. Let's go through the activity. We see one member inactive for about 21 days. This one is inactive for the last 3 weeks. Pretty inactive. Over here another one, 10 days. And from here down, I think 2 days is also some gap between active and inactive, but all other guys, so obviously 3 inactive ones, 43 active members, that's pretty good. Troop donations, we see over here 630. I don't know, did a new season start? Yes, there was quite a new season. We are only at 200. Wow. So pretty strong alliance donations over here. We see one guy who is very engaged in donating troops, but all of the others most of the others are also very active. Yes, the troop requests are also okay. Lifetime donations, Kratos, very high, 31,000. He's nearly equal with my own donation quote. Hyperion, the leader, is also very high. Very many active leaders or active members below or above 20,000 donations, some below. It's also a sign for activity. Stages, we see over here level 190, so probably some global, I don't know, also probably some atomic ages, probably rushed. We will see later. Then we see some global, I think, some industrials, oh, very many. Some enlightenments, oh, only some enlightenments. So this alliance is pretty much consisting out of a few enlightenment, very many industrial, and the most global, I think, or even some few atomic ages. We were requested or pleased by Hyperion alliance leader to come over here. So I think we will go for Hyperion. Serbia could also be a good choice. And I think we could go for Chris and Rob probably. Let's see how many bases we can do. Oh wow, Atomic Age. Here we are. Let's see which buildings he has already upgraded. He has updated his factory. Blacksmith. Where is the library? I searched for the library. Probably, am I blind? I don't see the library at all. Over here we have, I don't think it is upgraded. So in total, Hyperion was the highest metal count player we had in this alliance. Kingdom 1? No, I don't know. Imperium 1? I don't know how this league is called, but it's pretty much below 3,000 medals. So he, in a few medals, he will go and rise up to the highest league, which is possible with with very high league bonuses you can gain. Therefore, obviously, we see over here some kind of World War base layout or metal protection base layout. Quite definitely no care about the resources. That's how we will evaluate it. We have some specific defense layouts, some wall layers over here. We see to both sides we have in total 3 layers, which is definitely very strong. To the back side or front, however you want to call it, we have only 2 wall layers, and to the other side only 1 wall layer. But here very obviously we can see the Versailles. And so I think this guy is pretty high, and he has also researched. Let's look for the markets. Global age market, global age. So definitely, I'm sure this guy has researched the resistance chapters. Therefore, we have over here the mercenary camp, and we have the Versailles. That's coming or leading us to our next point, attractivity. And so this guy, Hyperion, wants to make the enemy attack or make him attractive to attack from the Versailles, because here obviously only 1 wall is protecting the town center, but it's definitely not that kind of easy to attack from over here. The position on the map, if we see, he has explored a nearly symmetrical square, square area, and his town center is nearly perfectly in the center. Pretty good, I would call this. Enemy influence, Russia or even Maxer. Let's see, he's atomic age. This stable is not maxed, this bunker is not upgraded, this table is maxed. Some of the towers are industrial. We only see 2 sniper towers, both unleveled. One of them is getting upgraded. The third sniper tower is still waiting. We have 2 mortars upgraded. 2 of them are still going. So in total, I would call him a rusher, definitely a rusher, because I think he was in the global age trying to max everything out. Then the 5.1 update came and he decided to not max out, but go up to the atomic age before he intended to, because you see his offense power is very, very strong. He has upgraded the field howitzers. I'm not quite sure whether these are Atomic Age ranged fighters. Please tell me in the comment section. But he has already German, so he has already 155 capacity. Field howitzers, the new supply cars, however they are called. Tanks are not upgraded, but I think very many of his offensive troops are upgraded, as well as the mercenary camp. So that was his focus, obviously, by upgrading to the next age previously, or before he intended to. Activity index. Where we have his houses, 1 house over here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 houses, pretty perfect, no more houses to go. So 16 workers, in total we see his walls at level 9 and level 10 for an engaged and active Atomic Age player, like I would anticipate and call him. This is below the average. Level 10 walls I think are average for Atomic Age players, or even end of Global Age players. So let's come to the conclusion that he is that you can call him a rusher, because also his generals are very weak, MacArthur seems to be weak. I don't know how high his other generals are, and the walls are not that high. Defensive buildings, where we have his mortars. I'm not pretty sure, but I think his mortars will stay very symmetrically if they would not be upgraded. It's a good way of using them, but to place them outside by upgrading, because they are not any more sensible while they are getting upgraded than putting a house inside, because they cannot defend. But I think they will be placed over here, so symmetrical. In total, this means that his mortars are very unprotected from this side over here, and from this side also quite unprotected. The cannon towers by the point of weakness compensations are also not placed that good. I think he placed them inside to protect his own bunkers, but in total from the outer side his mortars are definitely not protected. I think the mortar positions are not bad, but this both over here, and I anticipate that the other one will stay over here, are too exposed in my opinion. air defenses, where we have the air defenses. One air defense industrial max, one global max, industrial max, and where's fourth one, industrial max. He has pretty strong air defenses if you compare to all of the other defensive buildings. They are also a little bit spread out. Over here we have a very strong center of air defenses. Over here we have a little bit weaker air defense, but we have two towers over here. So in total, I think the air defense is not bad at his base. This one is nearly wasted because of the exponated position. Redoubts. 1, 2, 3. Where's the last one? I think he has 4 or even 5 redoubts possible. I think he has not built all of them. I only see 3 redoubts. No, 4 over here. So we see 2 enlightenment, 1 gunpowder, and 1 industrial redoubts. I also don't think that redoubts are that much important, but if you place them, if you locate them, choose the right directions. And this location is pretty okay, I would call it, because of the gate. This direction is not very good, but it's okay. You can call it okay, not good, because it's not at a corner, it's at a long side of the base. These both are complete exponated, so they are very to the edge of the base. We have one garrison over here, which is okay, but in total I don't think that the redoubt positions are that strong. Bunkers, we have both bunkers with some focus on them, because you see they are placed very much inside. You cannot reach them from the outer side. Yes, probably you can reach them from over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, you can reach them from over here with artilleries, but that's the onlyest way to reach them without crashing some walls. So you can pretty much call them defended as well. Or above this point, you see that the both of the bunkers are surrounded by each of them two anti-tank guns, and that's pretty strong, because if the enemy wants to get one of his heavy tanks by betrayal, he will definitely get smashed. So the bunkers are probably the strongest buildings with the strongest and most sensible locations inside this base. The sniper towers are very much exposed, both of them. He splits them up so that in total the enemy cannot take out both of them very easily, but the positions, I don't like them in total. I would probably change the positions, the locations, probably this locations over here and this over here. So you have nevertheless both of the sniper towers spread out, so don't so close together, but you have your whole base covered, both of the sniper towers unreachable from the outer side. And even, yes, I think to place the sniper towers in would be way better, because in this case you could also protect these mortars by some anti-tank guns, or even place these anti-tank guns over here, I don't know, but I would definitely locate the sniper towers more inside. World Wonders, we talked about, he has the Versailles, Acropolis, Blitzkrieg, and Notre Dame. Both of these ones are not interesting if you talk about defensive meanings. Both of these World Wonders cannot be destroyed. They can be destroyed, but the effects are staying active for the whole attack. So let's see how many buildings he is effecting with his Acropolis. Definitely his strongest tank depot. I think also second tank depot, command post, last tank depot. This bunker, I don't think that he will reach it, but this bunker he is reaching, two garrisons, I think that it was in total. But in total he has nearly all of his strongest buildings, which are the bunkers and the stables, only except for one bunker. He also has command post and two garrisons in. In total I think the location of the Acropolis is chosen good. The Versailles is placed at the most attractive place, very central, in front of his only one layer. Wall layer. You will also see that his strongest walls are over here, so it's pretty much hard to get through this wall. Here also I anticipate very many traps locations, or probably some traps locations. So the Versailles is also chosen at a very good place, I would call it. In total, exploration. From the exploration, he's an end of global ager, beginning of atomic ager, and he has explorated not that much of forests. There are, I think, 10 or even 11 forests remaining. I think that's a little bit below the average, because you can see his buildings are getting very close together and he don't have that much space. So I would definitely recommend exploring more forests. And in total, bugs using, he's not using any obvious bugs. We don't see the road being not upgraded. The road is to atomic global stage. So I can only call this base is quite thought about. I really like the thinkings which were made to create the space. The locations are most of them very sensible. I very, very like the position of the bunkers and of the Acropolis, but I don't like the positions of mortars and of the sniper towers. So pretty good base for the start. So the expectations for the next base are quite high because of this base. Here we are at Serbia, and here we have something pretty spectacular, which I could not recognize any time before. First, what I wanted to mention for you, with 5.1 update, we got the opportunity to build an additional mill and market. So a force mill and a forest market within the Atomic Age. This guy is the first one who did take chance or who used this opportunity, and we see over here the new markets. So we have a huge spread out of our resources, and so we have one big advantage. The advantage is that the enemy, instead of only 3 gold and 3 food buildings, has to destroy 4 gold and 4 food buildings, which means it's harder for the enemy to get at least all of your resources, and as well you will gain, if you have upgrades them, very many more hit points, and that means the 100% destruction of your base will get harder for the enemy because there are more hit points in total. But you also have one very big disadvantage, and that one is that you get 2 new buildings which you have to protect, so to waste some new walls. But what is the most spectacular about this base is, I wanted to call you, look at the leak where he is. He's pretty high at Kingdom 2, I don't know, he's at 2400 medals approximately, I think, but his town center is pretty much exposed. So if here are some traps, I would call this very weak, but that guys of you who have already seen or watched my video about why to protect the town center even at higher leaks outside, understand now why I'm meaning that it's very sensible from 2000 up to 2800, probably 2900 medals, to locate your town center outside. I don't want to explain it because it's a very complex topic. If you are interested, just watch my video for metal hunters, secret tips for metal hunters, the video is called, I think. There I in detail explain why it's sensible to place the town center outside even when you go for medals. But this guy obviously has a town center outside, so it could be some trap for the enemy because we have some towers over here and one sniper tower, so that the enemy getting attracted from the town center, but he also could have his town center on purpose outside without protection. Both situations are cool, and yes, we'll talk about. He's at over 2,300 medals, and nevertheless, town center is outside, so I will evaluate this base for resource protection. And therefore, we have to call about to talk about spread out. We see 2 global, 1 Atomic market, 3 atomic mills, pretty much because he is upgrading his troops, obviously. And you see, first troop he upgraded was his Greek, so his nation-specific tank, his cavalry. Pretty good, I would call it. Also, his trade goods are upgraded, so very good. Where we have the locations. First, we have 2 market, 1 market, 1 mill outside. But these ones are the new ones he got, so they are not upgraded that much. They are very weak, and they don't store that much of resources that you would have to care about this. If they are getting higher, he has definitely to get them in protection, but currently we don't have to mention them. So we are only talking about 3 markets, 3 mills. We have all of them protected inside. In the very center of his base, we have command post and the oil. Then we have in one chamber gold food, in another chamber gold, another chamber food, another chamber gold, and another chamber food. So in total, we have nearly all of his resources protected in another chamber, except for this boss. So the locations are very, very wise chosen, I would call it. The spread out also is nearly perfect, I would call, because the food you have to come from over here, and from over here. Same as for the gold over here, and over here, over here. So the spread out as well as the location are very, very thought about. I personally would not take the castle inside because it's wasting that much of space and not that strong to defend. Therefore, I would take probably 1 market inside. But nevertheless, this structure of the base is quite well thought about, and I don't can criticize anything currently about the locations of the resource buildings. Russia or Maxer, we see Atomic Age player with Enlightened Mortars, so I don't think we have to talk about. These mortars are 3 ages below his current age, this mortar 2 ages below. He has one stable from Enlightenment Age, one industrial stable, one global maxed out stable, one medieval stable. In total, this guy is very, very obviously a rusher. Activity index, where we have his houses. 1, 2, 3 houses, 4, 5, 6 houses, 7, 8 houses. I don't see an estate. So in total he has about 8 workers, that's the maximum. His walls are at level 9, and like I told you, at the base of Hyperion, I think. Level 9 walls are for engaged and active Atomic Age players, pretty below the average. And also we see his gates are... Oh no, the gates are at level 10. Mm-hmm. Level 9. These bows are at level 10. Look at the metal at the ground. Here we don't have. So he has some of his gates at level 9, some at level 10. I would definitely recommend them upgrading on level 10, because like I always tell you, the gates are weaker than the walls, so you have to upgrade them faster or... Yes, faster or higher than your walls are. In total, I don't think that the walls are very high and very strong. Defensive buildings. We have all of the mortars at the outside. So very exposed mortars. I think they are getting... You can really easily get them from the outer side. So when I would attack with my British troops, I don't think that this base would be a huge challenge. I don't want to be arrogant, but the most dangerous buildings are the mortars for me, and I pretty much don't have to care about them because they are very, very much spread out and they are very exposed. So from the outer side, you can start over here, rally for this mortar, wait, let your troops come over here, then rally your troops for the side, take over here with your planes because you have pretty much no air defense over here. The mortar is getting slowed down, rally for the next mortar, and in this style, I think you can get nearly all of his mortars. Compensation of weaknesses. We have all of these strong cannon towers. He has 5 pieces of them, and all of them are global maxed, but all of them are at the inner side of his base to protect the oil, obviously. I don't think that this compensates the weaknesses of the mortar very good, and also the mortars are not, in this case, quite not able to protect the cannon towers. I don't like this fact about this base. Air defenses. We have... 1 industrial air defense, 1 global maxed, another global maxed, whereas the 4th one industrial. So 2 very, very strong air defenses and 2 very weak. So quite, it looks like some opponents. The weak ones, by the way, are exposed. That's okay, not very good, but I think it's okay. And the strong ones are inside the space. This one is located very good. This one is located okay, but I think in an attack you can really easy and really fast crash this strong air defense. And then over here we have a quite exposed... place where you can get with your air units. Bunkers. 1 bunker is at the inner side and 1 at the outer side. Both are pretty, pretty low. They are only built in industrial, not even upgraded to industrial max, as well as global max or even atomic. So only MK1s are spawning. This bunker is pretty much at the inner side, so very good defended. And you also have 3, that's pretty much overkill. You have 3 cannon towers directly in the surrounding of this bunker, so you don't even have to think about using betrayal over here. It's completely senseless. This is pretty much protected, it's okay, and we have 1 cannon tower nearly next to it. But I don't like this position because the cannon tower is very easy crashed, and when you take over this MK tank, you can easily get this chamber as well as his strongest tank depot. In total, I think this one is perfectly protected, this one not so good. Sniper towers. We have 1 sniper tower behind the town center, obviously, to get rid of enemy troops which are getting dropped over here and trying to snipe his town center. 2 of his sniper towers are all at the inner side of his base. He has the maximum amount of 3 sniper towers for Atomic Age, but all of them are unleveled in industrial stage. He can upgrade them once, twice, 3 times, all of them. So they are pretty low and not very strong. But the locations of... The both sniper towers at the inner side are quite okay, so I like the location but not the upgrade status. World Wanderers, he has Acropolis, Versailles, the Notre Dame, and at least, where's the fourth one? Oh, he didn't even build it. Oh, that's very weak, I think. In Industrial Age, you get that powerful World Wonders and you don't even have built your one. That's a clearly disadvantage for the space, I would call it. I already talked about Versailles and Acropolis. Those of you who don't know about the special effects, you can go back in the video to Hyperion or to other videos of me. I always explain it. No, I don't. I won't explain it anymore explicitly. This Versailles is pretty good protecting over here this edge and also this entrance to the town center. So he obviously has placed it over here. The location is quite okay, not very perfectly, but I even would not know where to place it in a better way. The Acropolis will effect bunker, probably this weak stable, but that's not care about. Here is some medieval ponies will spawn some medieval unicorns, so no care about. Enlightenment Age garrison, industrial tank depot, enlightenment stable, industrial now enlightenment garrison. So in total we have to focus about this bunker, tank depot and stable. So I think this is not very strong. His strongest strongest tank depot he has, the Global Age tank depot, is not inside of the Acropolis. That's such a huge waste. Why are you doing this, my friend? I would try to get this bunker located over here to also have it inside of the Acropolis, and then probably switch the positions of this tank depot with this stable, for example, because whether these ponies are getting 300 more hit points is quite not any important, but whether this strong global age maxed out battle tanks are getting about 3,000 more hit points is very important. So I would definitely recommend change this both locations. Exploration, if we see, he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Wow, 10 pieces of forest not explored. You see how close all of his buildings are staying. With exploration, he's definitely below the average. Recommend more, my friend, I would call you, or I would recommend you to make it the enemy stronger by spread out your buildings to get 100%. At least bucks using, he's not bucks using, but his road is upgraded to global max, and he's only at level 188, I think. So in total, I don't think he's using bugs. The first configuration of this layout I really, really like, but the walls are pretty low. The mortars are quite wasted. I don't understand the locations of the stable and this tank depot. Yes, in total, I don't think that this layout is quite so good like the first one we saw. But also this one is quite okay, and you can't criticize big things over here, only some minor things like probably the locations of specific buildings. Let's go on. Here we are at Chris. Wow, maze layout looks pretty spectacular. Oh no, okay. So at the first look, this layout looks pretty spectacular. I also see some very cool details he thought about. So for example, in the first look, it looks pretty unstructured, all of these pieces of road. But in total, you see, he connected all possible buildings to his town center to gain more hit points for the town center. That's a pretty positive aspect, I would call. Some very disadvantages I can't really know why he is doing is, for example, why he placed all of this building so close together inside his walls. So enemies can pretty easy plan and anticipate where his traps are located. So for example, if you are rallying right inside over here and only taking, if you are starting probably from over here, then this tower will be crashed instantly. Just drop one of your wall miners. This one will go, crash this wall, you can rally inside pretty easy. Then you can disable probably over here, and probably over here. So you have three places disabled. If not even, you only have to disable in first situation over here. Then your troops are at this both locations, and here can't be any traps at all. But from over here you can easily shoot to the town center. So the range of the inner wall layer is quite not very good. But let us start from the beginning. You see, he is also pretty high at his medals, and he is going to protect his town center, obviously. This means this is a metal protection base layout, and we don't want to evaluate the locations of the resource buildings. Therefore, defensive structures, wall layers. We have one inner wall layer, which is pretty good at the most sites. Over here, pretty good. Over here, weak, very weak. Good, weak, and good. I think over here it's also again weak, because from the outer side you can reach the town center, and that's quite effect which we want to avoid. Therefore, I think it's the most easiest way to come over here and crash his town center, as well as get access to two mortars, a sniper tower, and something like this. Enemy influence. Yes, enemy influence. We see many holes inside this maze layout. Therefore, it's called maze layout, because you have some structures where you want to go the enemy, and where you make it attractive for the enemy to attack, but where your traps obviously are located, so that you can smash healing cards very early in the game, because they are going crazy when you rally at a specific point inside the base, and they are choosing the fastest way, which is quite not to wait to get through the wall, but they are going for this on purpose lit entrances. Rusher or Maxer, he's level 187. We see industrial, at least enlightenment mortars, low air defense, two strong air defenses. Industrial, enlightenment. Okay, we see many enlightenment buildings. So in total, I would call him a rusher. 1, 2, 3. Where's the force depot? Over here, force. Okay. Activity index. I think where we have the houses. I already saw one estate. First thing, what is coming to my mind, but which is quite no point about his base. I saw that the estate is quite not changing. All houses are changing from every age to get to stay actual or to stay updated, but the estate is not growing anymore. It still looks like an industrial house. Pretty ridiculous. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He has 8 houses, as well as the... Oh wow, that's interesting. 8 houses, 16 citizens. With the estate, 19 citizens. With the opera house, 20 citizens. And with the Chinese nation, 21 citizens. This guy has obviously the hugest available citizens amount in the complete game. There is nobody who can have more citizens. 21 citizens, that's pretty awesome, I would call it. I never seen something before, something like this before. His walls are only a level 8 and level 9, so this is very low, I would call it, for an industrial ager. We even have some gunpowder age players which have higher walls. I think therefore he would have to care about. And also what I see, his strongest walls are at a place or are at locations where I definitely would not attack. I would attack from over here. Don't know why here he has his weakest base walls. defensive buildings. We have all of the mortars at the inner range. That's quite okay. I don't understand why he spreaded them out so much. He could locate them a little bit closer to the town center by easily takes this road away over here. So he will lose one road connection to the town center, probably. But I would not care about these 100 hit points for getting my mortar protected instead of the... Yes, the mortars are quite okay positioned, I would call it, because you can't reach them from the outer side. How is the compensation of weaknesses? This mortar is pretty good protected by two cannon towers. This one is okay protected. I would locate this cannon tower instead of this drill tower or this oil well, I don't know, at the outer side to get a perfect protection. This one is also okay protected by this cannon tower, but not perfectly. This one is pretty perfectly protected, but I also don't know what this cannon tower is, why it is located over here. The compensation of weaknesses is quite okay. I would not call it bad. Air defenses, we already talked about. We see one very weak industrial, one strong industrial, and two global age maxed out air defenses. In total, his air defense is pretty strong, and he used all of them, nearly all of them, 3 out of 4 at the inner base layout, and one at the in the second wall layer. So pretty strong air defense, I would call it. Very good. I like this point about this base. Where are the redoubts located? One redoubt, gunpowder, second gunpowder, third gunpowder, fourth gunpowder, fifth gunpowder. So he has 5 redoubts, maximum amount, but none of them upgraded. All of them are so unbelievable weak. I know redoubts to upgrade takes the longest amount of time as well as the highest amount of gold. Therefore, you probably skipped them. But also the locations are really ridiculous. This location is quite good because of the entrance over here, but these locations are pretty ridiculous. Yes, we have a garrison over here, but this redoubt will be crashed that fast in an attack that it can't do anything. Also pretty unspectacular. This redoubt is placed, you can call it okay because of the gate, but in total I don't like the positions of the redoubts at all. He obviously put no focus on his redoubts. Bunkers, we have one bunker, very low. Where's the second one? Over here. The second bunker is... okay, because of the Acropolis, I see. Second bunker is industrial max. The other bunker is industrial build. In total, I don't think that they are very high. But the locations are quite okay. Both of them are protected at the inner side of his base. And we have cannon towers right in the surroundings. So none of these bunkers is not surrounded by cannon towers. From this bunker, we have 2 ones. And from this, even 3 cannon towers. That's pretty strong. Sniper towers. We have 3 sniper towers. All of them, I think, upgraded to, let's see, industrial max, it looks like. Yes, industrial max. So definitely stronger sniper towers and very well chosen locations. You have even 2 chances. First chance to spread your sniper towers symmetrically in your base. And that one he did. Or other chance to place them all at one location and make it very attractive for the enemy to attack from this location. And then care with traps about the way he will attack. He just spread them out very symmetrical. And I think this is the first opportunity. And he did it very well. I think the defense of sniper towers is very sufficient at his base. World Wonders, we have the Versailles, the Opera House of Sydney, the Statue of Liberty, and the Acropolis. Are this all World Wonders? 1, 2, 3, 4, and the Notre Dame. In total, only Acropolis and Versailles have defensive meanings or relations. We'll talk about them. I won't explain the specific characteristics of both of these world wonders. If you are interested, just go back in the video to Hyperion. There I explained what is special about these both world wonders, or watch any of my other videos where I also explain it. The Versailles is slowing down all enemies over here, so if you want to attack from over here, this is quite not a good idea. Therefore, his defense is a little bit weaker over here. He placed all of his defender-producing buildings pretty over here, and therefore it looks very attractive to attack from over here, but it is indeed not. At second, we have the Acropolis, and the Acropolis will effect 1 stable, tank depot, bunker, garrison. Yes, that's pretty much all. He got at least 1 tank depot not in total, but he has 2 tank depots and the stable, as well as both bunkers. So nearly all of his strongest buildings, which are important to get by the effect of the Acropolis, he got. So since the Acropolis position is definitely okay, nothing to complain about. The using of, or the exploration, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, 10 forests to explore anymore. That's pretty low for Atomic Age. Definitely get rid of more forests. Your base is too close to... yes, you don't have enough spread out, I think. Bugs using, he's not bugs using. All of his roads are global max. In total, I would think this base is pretty thought about. Many aspects I really like. The mortar locations are good, quite good locations of the air defenses, sniper towers are good located, good effects or effectivity of the Acropolis, Versailles is located very good, but he has too many useless buildings inside his walls. Why you placed all of this oil wells inside and this fucking crappy market? I mean, how much gold is stored over here? About 100 gold? Why did you place it inside? You can get very, very much more important buildings over here. Yes, in total, I think the bass layout is definitely very okay. This guy is thinking about what he's doing, and the most aspects are okay, but there are also some very trivial, very easy and simple aspects which he not thought about, and therefore I can only tell you, in total, this bass is okay, with some very good, as well as some very bad aspects. Let's go for the last one, which we have to be a little bit faster, because we don't have that much time. Here we are, guys, at the last layout for this episode, at Rob's bass, and I have a little bit to wonder about this layout. From the first view, it looks pretty unspectacular. It looks like what we are calling actually a sim space. Just put most of your buildings inside and take a wall outside. And I don't know why he is wasting that much of wall for all of this kind of buildings. But let's evaluate. Nevertheless, it's a base and we can evaluate. He's at also Imperium 3, whatever, 2600 medals probably, I think. 2400 up to 2600, something between, I think. So I will evaluate this as metal protection base layout or World War base layout, no resource protection. This means, do we have any influence on the enemy? I don't see. Because I don't see any site or any way to attack which shall be made attractive for the enemy. Defensive layers or wall layers. We have one very strict inner wall layer next to the town center and one very, very huge outside. In total, this makes not very much sense to me because by crashing the outer side and rallying in, you have very good access to most of the defensive buildings as well as the town center. Location at the map, it's pretty much the center. I think the perfect center would be over here, so it's a little bit more to the upper left side. Russia or Maxer, we see a global age guy with some enlightenment buildings at all. So I think there are some enlightenment buildings, like a tower, two towers, garrison. But in total, I would call him a maxer. Now, not completely, he's some hybrid form. There are some buildings which I definitely would max out, like the towers, for example. The garrisons probably not, but also the mortar I would upgrade once more. But there are also very many other buildings he has on industrial max stage. Activity index, where we have his houses. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 houses, I don't see an estate. So 8 houses with level 9 walls, pretty low for global age. Some level 10 walls. The gates are most at level 9. Here we see some level 10 gates. One indeed only, I think. One gate. In total, I think these walls are pretty below the average and the gates are also not that strong. I would recommend to upgrade the gates to one, at least two or even three times higher to have them not as a weakness inside your wall layers. Defensive buildings, where we have the mortars. This mortar is pretty spread out to the outer side. I can't understand why he don't... That's a perfect example. Why is this redoubt at the inner side? It just cannot fire. It can only fire when the walls are broken. And then it's completely senseless. By easily switching mortar and redoubt would be a perfect match. Because you only have a win-win situation. The redoubt is next to the gate. So your defenders will fluctuate over here and draw enemies into the redoubt. And the mortar is very protected at the inner side. But this constellation is pretty senseless at all. This mortar is okay protected. You can reach him from the outer side, but only five range troops. This is perfectly, not perfectly, but this is complete protected. You can't reach it without destroying the walls. This one is not protected because you can reach it over here. Weakness compensations. We see again nearly all of the cannon towers at the very center. This mortar is unprotected. This one is a little bit protected in total. I think the weakness compensations are very low and not very good. Established at this base. Air defenses. We have one industrial air defense, one global air defense, industrial, but there should be a fourth one, I think. Probably he has not built it currently. Let's take a closer look. No, I don't see a fourth one. So two times industrial, one times global. They are pretty good spread out. so that you have nearly all over the base some air defenses. I like this point, the air defense is quite okay. Redoubts, we talked about, this redoubt is pretty senseless at all. Same at this redoubt, because it's too much to the inner side. When this can't, both of them can start fire, it's too late, troops are already inside. This one is also very senseless. To replace them with the tower would be way better, but so it's senseless. It's not at an edge or at a corner of a base. This one is also nearly senseless because it's too far away from any gates or from any corners. In total, I think the redoubts are placed definitely a little bit bad. Bunkers, we have one bunker over here. Second is getting upgraded and is located over here. Both are inside of the walls. This bunker is not protected at in any ways because we don't have any cannon towers next to it. So if the enemy will steal one of your tanks with betrayal, it can easily destroy most of these buildings. And there we have one maxed out global tank depot, a maxed out mortar and two towers. So very essential defensive buildings for you. This one is good protected because of the cannon tower in the next surrounding to it. Sniper towers. We have two sniper towers. Both are unleveled, so very weak, but located in the center of the base. You can... 1, 2, 3, 4. You cannot disable both at once. That's a good point. And they have nearly access to the complete base. Only nearly, not complete. Over here, I think they have a blind spot. In total, the location is quite okay, but the upgrade status of the sniper towers is very, very weak. World Wonders, we have Versailles, Notre Dame, Statue of Liberty, and Acropolis. So again, we always see over here the same wonders like Versailles, Acropolis, and Notre Dame. Again, I won't mention the aspects about Versailles and Acropolis. If you are interested, skip back or go back to the video to Hyperion, the first base we reviewed. There you can hear about or look at any other base layout videos I uploaded. There I'm explicitly explaining why Versailles and Acropolis are that strong. Versailles, the location is quite not bad, but I also don't see any advantages by it. He just placed it next to the base. No, it's not very obvious or very attractive for an enemy to attack over here, so I don't see a big positive advantage by placing it here. The Acropolis will affect this bunker if it gets upgraded, one tank depot, and wow, nearly one garrison. So in total, currently only one building where it is sensible. When it's upgraded, it will affect two buildings. In total, you should always care about that the Acropolis will deal or even effect all of your tank depots and, if possible, all of your bunkers. In this base, only two of them are affected, and therefore that you are using, or not using, that you are wasting space and walls for placing the Acropolis inside of your walls. That is definitely not enough. In total, if we compare about, oh, we have some points to go. Exploration, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I think 11 forests to go. Again, a guy which skips his exploration and don't have that much space to spread out his buildings. Definitely spread it more out by exploring more forests. It's below the average in your age. No bugs used. The road is industrial. So in total, if we have to sum up, the first bases we saw were pretty much my favorites. There are very logical and very effective thoughts about or thoughts behind where you can see the structure is very well placed, the locations are well chosen, and the buildings are very good upgraded in some cases. Only some minor disadvantages, but the last base over here is the base I would improve the most. I don't want to insult you, my friend, but I don't see any positive aspects except for the air defenses probably in this base. I would in total restructure it because there are very sufficient problems about defending anything, whether resources or the town center. So guys, we are at the end of this episode. Hopefully it entertained you. If you want to be in my next episode, like I already mentioned at the beginning of the video, give me your name with current spelling, with correct spelling of your alliance, probably some additional information to provide me, like the medal count, glory count, number of members, your language, whatever, so that I can find you, and I will care about finding you in one of the next episodes. So guys, I think we'll see us soon back to the World War Attacks, your domination tips.